I can say something, and I hope that the press will not hang me tomorrow. You cannot make changes in 1 year for things that didn't work over 30 years.
I agree.
This is the truth, and sorry, I cannot lie. We made mistakes in our country over the last decades. If someone believes that we can change that in 1 or 2 years, sorry, we cannot. Because there is also cultural change that we need to do. There is structural changes that we need to do. And both of them, they take time. It's not like a bottom. I put the top bottom and then I have something. Sorry, the lady was before you. And ladies, we have to give them a place.
My name is Christina Zigomala. I work in the advertising and marketing sector. And we are in the European capital. And so far, nobody has touched upon European funding. So if I think of the 80 billion euro projected by Barroso for research and development, or 30 billion euro unused money for training and for the education of young people, what part do they play in your investment program? Cooperation projects with European funding?
I don't know. Sorry. I really don't know.
The other members of the panel know, because I'm very
concerned. I really don't know. What I know, it's sorry for being so crass, but I can speak 5 minutes, but I don't know what I can say. I really don't know. And I think, I don't know if saying that someone has. Today we have a problem in Greece today. This problem has a name, and is the five concessions. There's the five big concession projects in Greece. These are five projects that they are stopped to work because of the lack of funding. Mm-hmm. Why? Because of various reasons. Some of them they are explained because of the recession, because of the business environment, because of the funding structure. The bottom of line is that since 1 year there's dead projects, they stop projects. There is a decision now taken that we have to refinance this project for the structural funds.
Yeah.
Okay.
If I may add to this, sorry for that.
Yeah.
Unleashing such powers from structural funds and improving, because I think that's what you mean, improving the degree of absorption of these funds, which are very obviously critical for, I mean, it's free money
exactly.
At the end of the day.
Exactly.
It's not free money. This is the problem, the point. It's money that they are there to make this money free. We have to change
a lot of
regulations.
Exactly.
This is the point.
Yeah.
It's not free money.
No.
It's money that the existing. To take this money, this is very different that there is free money and money that's there.
It's not
free.
Actually, it's money appropriated in the budget. So in the community budget, it's appropriated in the various structural funds. There are within the EU at EU level there are solid mechanisms for this to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Greece's level of absorption of this money, historically in the last period, is pitiful. I mean, we absorb, I think, in the area of 20-25% of what we are entitled to.
Exactly.
Now, there are structural changes, and obviously there's huge pressure from the international environment, from the Troika.
Yeah.
Let alone the sheer necessity of us to absorb this money. So there is a parallel effort to improve, simplify the process and improve this rate, which is outside the ambit of investing in Greece. That's a multidisciplinary effort. It takes place within various ministries. It is a problem on which Greece is highly aware. But so I think that, well, to put it simply, it can only improve. I mean, it's so bad, it can only improve.